Now, former prosecutor David Ruoff is joining us now to go over some of these very important issues. So first of all, could a death penalty verdict be thrown out because of how a judge described reasonable doubt to a jury?
Absolutely. If the trial judge made a mistake in defining what reasonable doubt is under our law to the jury, then the verdict would be tainted and a new trial would be ordered.
Big argument over whether this case should have been moved, a high-profile case, if it should be in a different venue. How heavily will justices weigh that argument?
That was one of the main arguments that the defense pressed today, mainly because of the way the state developed the evidence that Officer Briggs was a protector of the community, and that was one of the most significant things that the defense argued about. So the court will have to take that matter very, very seriously.
So we saw the demonstrators outside, many hoping that the legislature will take up the legality of the death penalty in the state of New Hampshire in the coming session. Could that have an impact on this case right now?
Well, certainly the attitude towards the death penalty is an atmospheric that the justices might think about. I don't think it'll have a direct effect on their ultimate decision. Obviously, if the death penalty is repealed, then that will have to be resolved if it, in fact, is repealed.
Are we in uncharted territory here? I mean, the state hasn't had an execution since 1939.
Oh, absolutely in an uncharted territory. There's no facility for the death penalty to be carried out. There are many challenges that were made today, and still, today is not really the end of it for Mr. Addison. He still has several federal appeals that he can follow in the event that any of these are not successful that he can follow. And it'll take years before we ultimately know.
Any estimate on how long the justices could take to decide what we heard today, and how long for the entire appeals process?
Normally, it's about 90 days after oral argument that they issue an order, but this was an extraordinary appeal, mm-hmm. and an extraordinary day at that court. I would be surprised if we saw anything before next summer.
All right. Former prosecutor David Ruoff, thanks for your insight
today. Thank you very much.